welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive studio. Joining me now is Garrett Ainsworth, the president and CEO of District Metals Corp. And Garrett, it's nice to see you. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks very much, Steve.
Really interesting company, fairly new company. We'll talk about your projects in just a second and where you are, but maybe give me some background on District Metals Corp.
Yeah, so it all started up in the middle of 2018 when myself and some colleagues joined District Metals, and we had a mandate to go out and find a highly prospective base and or precious metal project somewhere around the globe within a good jurisdiction.
And that jurisdiction is Sweden. So tell me a little bit about Sweden itself and what you liked about it.
Yeah, I mean, initially in late 2018, I looked at Scandinavia, and it really did catch my attention as a great jurisdiction. You know, Finland, Sweden, Norway. They're very like pro mining there. It's part of the euro, but it acts independently from the euro as well. It's a very straightforward permitting process. And one thing I'll notice that the Fraser Institute actually has Sweden ranked number 10 for investment attractiveness, which is actually higher than any province or territory in Canada for 2019, which is sad in its own way. But it's very pro mining, and there's some significant players in Sweden that make it a good place to be.
Yeah, you've found a couple of properties there, so let's go through them one at a time. Tell me about the two properties specifically, and what attracted you to them.
Yeah, so in late 2019, I was introduced to EMX Royalty Corp. They have a wonderful portfolio of projects, mostly in Norway and in Sweden. And I went through all of their projects, and you know, there was one in particular that really stood out, and that's the polymetallic Tomtebo property. We also picked up a earlier stage project called Trollberget. But that's not really a main focus. We'll be pushing that along slowly, but Tomtebo is an advanced stage exploration property. It has two historic mines on it with workings or exploration drilling that's down to the 200 meter level, and it shows mineralization open along strike and at depth. So I mean, the whole take here is that we're not worried about making a discovery. Although there is very good potential for discovery to occur on the property, but there's already known mineralization, and now our job is to prove it up tonnage-wise.
How much work had been done there leading up to that, and how long ago was that work done? Do you have a lot of access to the data?
It's not as good of a data collection system as what you find in Canada, whereby you write assessment reports, submit it to the government. But we have found some pretty significant drill data in archives. It's partial at best, but from what I can tell from the drilling assays and whatnot, it really supports that there's a significant mineralizing system on the property.
So how do you now, I know that you've recently raised some capital as well, so how do you now take that capital, and what's the plan going forward to take a look at Tomtebo?
Yeah, so we raised about $2.4 million. We had some excellent, very prominent investors join us, like Sprott Global, Commodity Capital, Stevens Asset Management out of San Francisco. It really just bolsters the existing shareholders that we have. So I'm really proud of our shareholder base going forward, and that's a really important step. So first off, right out of the hop, the project in Sweden has not really seen any systematic modern exploration. So step one, we're gonna fly an airborne electromagnetic survey. This has actually never been done on the project, and that's one of the first things you do when you're exploring in a terrain for sulfide-rich volcanic massive sulfide deposits. They're very conductive. And then there's also parts of the mineralization that are somewhat magnetic. So we plan on starting that in July. It'll be a first time this project's ever seen it. We'll be able to see down to depths of 500 meters or deeper, which is very significant because the nearby mines in the region have mineral resources down to 1600 meters. And it starts actually from surface. So there's huge vertical extent potential. Then we'll be following up on the ground with some geologists, ground truthing some of the airborne anomalies, and going to visit some of the mineral occurrences, going back to the historic mines, doing some geological mapping, sampling, prospecting, and that should take place in about August, September. And we also I've already set things up, so we're going to be bringing in a local expert who was the chief geo with Boliden, and was largely responsible for getting the Garpenberg mine, which is 25 kilometers to the southeast, to a very large deposit of where it's at right now. So bringing him in, it will be a very good complement, because he knows the region, he knows the styles of mineralization and what structure means to put everything together to firm up drill targets for a drill program in the first half of 2021.
Wow. Well, it sounds like it's going to be a super busy summer, and we look forward to sharing some of the results when you get them and seeing all the unique and exciting things you have planned for this project. Garrett, thank you so much. Great to talk to you.
Yeah, thanks very much, Steve. Talk to you later.
All right. Garrett Ainsworth, President and CEO of District Metals Corp.